It's been a spectacle here, a dream atmosphere. And I've got some outstanding company with me because the seven-time English national champion, the chopper on topper, my friend and co-commentator, Jill Parker. Jill, how you doing?
I'm doing great, Adam. I'm looking forward to this final of the mixed doubles. We've seen some fantastic table tennis today. Well, in fact, all week we have. So I'm sure it'll be great, man.
Right now, it's the big brother, the defending champion, and the top female, Kasumi Ishikawa, representing Japan. So, Jill, I know I just gave a few ears full there. I'll give you a chance to share a thought or two if you'd like.
Oh, well, now you're always full of, I was going to say useless information, but
true.
No, useful information. You're what a...
Half and half.
A wealth of everything in your brain, and it goes so quickly, so...
Thanks. You're like, there's got to be a better word than knowledge. It's definitely not that. Something similar.
No, you have got a wealth of table tennis knowledge.
Thanks. So 2 points in the lead. The Chinese pair on the receive, converting both of theirs.
Oh, picked up that well. Moves in. Just slightly stepped in with that. And on the backhand, Turner serve.
Oh, the timing. There's the one right on top of the bounce. It's like they have completely different jobs on the table. Liu Shiwen, her 20, her location is right at the back of the table. Xu Xin will sweep around behind the table and take care of that general region for anything that comes there. Ooh, touch shot for a second bounce.
Yeah, that was a nice play there by Ishikawa. Just touched it short.
Fun fact, Chinese rubber on the Japanese star's forehand. A little bit harder, slower in the short game. Ooh, edge of the table. Xu Xin is so quick to apologize. If it were for the championship point, I mean, it was such a good shot anyway. There might have been a chole and then the apology or acknowledgement, as Don would say.
Yeah, but it was a great angle as well.
Yeah, he's filled with great angles. Sounds weird, but it's true. He can just do anything from anywhere. I'm okay. Jill just hit me in the knee. That was the sound you heard her saying, oop, didn't mean to hit you in the knee.
Brilliant, brilliant. Isn't it there? I mean, every opportunity they take, you know, put on the pressure in this game.
Yeah, I think for me, it's a good sign that Maharu Yoshimura's in position for this, but he didn't really rely on much topspin on the counter. It was a very flat hit back, which is pretty low percentage. Short side attempted. Kasumi not freaking out, holding her ground well. Here the quote is, Liu Shiwen dealt with the ghost of the 2015 final. I like that. That's like poetry from Yap Yo Wai. Wrote me on Facebook, and I'm like, wow, that could not have been better said. For those of you who didn't see it, Liu Shiwen in 2015 goes up 2-0 in game seven. Ding Ding sprains her ankle and comes back hobbling to win the title. That's two in a row for Ding Ding, but the third will not happen this year. She's been knocked out. Liu Shiwen, with some confidence right now, has to be running on high.
And they're full steam ahead here on this first game. And now right from level. They played aggressive table tennis.
This is the real test. In 2017, there were no strong Chinese pairs. Ooh, strawberry. There it is. The first strawberry of today comes courtesy of Maharu Yoshimura. Thank you for the delicious receive. One game point saved, seven to go. Two! He does it the other way, gets it off the top of the net, but it's the short side of the table. Strawberries everywhere. I don't know if I've ever seen two in succession so fast. Oh, thank you for the lesson. Masterclass with Yoshimura. And the punch on the backhand here of Ishikawa, Ken Ma Lin. Silenced for a moment, just deep in thought after those two strawberries, but how long can they really keep up such incredible shots? That was Ma Lin from the corner. Break off the net, but there's the Chole in the crucial moment. 11-5, Xu Xin able to make that threat from deep in the backhand court. Remember, this is for the title. Will the Japanese pair retain? They've got an uphill battle right now. Liu Xuan and Xu Xin, they are out for blood. Back for game number two, the Japanese pair down after losing game one, 5-11. Now, one thing that hasn't been talked about so much so far, Jill, Mahadu Yoshimura has very tricky serves. In 2015 on the World Tour, he became a subject of study around the world with his shovel kick serves. Perfect placement into the middle. He's also very fast and limber. You know, I feel like his arm is more like an elephant trunk, like it has 40 elbows on it. It can just bend so many different ways.
Good use of the wrist and elbow, and obviously that's what generates the speed and spin.
Good closure from Kasumi, apologizing, acknowledging the top of the net she got there. I like the new uniform, subtle, but that blue collar really makes them pop. I'm into the fashion of table tennis, that's my world. I'm actually wearing a shirt much like the Chinese national team shirt right now.
Yeah, same colors.
Maybe a few more, but more or less.
And looking smart, too.
Thanks. That's British English for handsome, right? You said smart, I look smart?
I didn't say that,
what'd you say?
Handsome. I said you look smart.
Smart, yeah, British English for handsome, right?
No.
I'll ask you later. I think I get it, though. So 4-1, quite a different start here. Remember, they only got 5 points in game number one. Now, this is the alternate order of play. Xu Xin receiving Mahadu Yoshimura's serves. Over the table as well. Now, I think Mahadu Yoshimura, while he's not world-ranked number two, is still a bit like the Xu Xin of the Japanese national team in the sense that whoever plays doubles with him tends to be quite successful. So 5-1, can't do too much better coming into the first towel break. Even though he misses this shot, I think this is the right tactic, Jill. He's got to be quick to play pressure back.
Yeah, he's got to play hard because that stops the Chinese getting in.
It's funny, I was going to say work hard, play hard, but in this sense, it's actually the same thing. Usually it's not.
Oh, and that was a great backhand, wasn't it? Off the bounce.
Yeah.
She's famous for Liu Xuan and she played against Ding Ning in the semi-final of the singles. You know, she won one game, 11-love. You wouldn't see that very often against the ex-world champion, but she did play well today.
Oh, the timing. Ishikawa bowled on top of the bounce. This ball sat up, but still not so much that most players would play it as flat and early as Ishikawa did. Yeah, that ball was getting closer to its peak, but maybe just more than halfway there.
Whoa.
Ooh, a dart of a chop block goes long. So Don and I, Don Parker, you'd know him if you saw him, Jill. He was here with me, and we had a chance to see some of the most deadly chop blocks. And this is after watching a match with Ma Long. Some of the most deadly chop blocks we've seen from Koki Niwa. Mahadu Yoshimura has some too when he needs them. Good angle here. Kasumi Ishikawa quickly second guessing herself, saying, come on, counterattack. You could see the body language, the self-coaching. A little bit passive here, trying to cover and block, but it was a wide shot bending away.
Yeah, it was a lot of side spin on that. But I think she's been handling Xu Xin very well.
Agreed, well said, Jill. Jill's laughing at me. We had a little talk about Xu and Xin and different fun ways. You know, one thing that I'm most impressed with in terms of Liu Shuwen is her serve and her after motion. The way she wraps around, I've seen it so much in doubles, and it's that forehand serve from the forehand side. Not too far. Ishikawa fooled, chasing it down. Clever play from the Chinese side. Xuxin again. That backhand, so much wrist. He turns it what feels like somewhere between 180 and 270 degrees. A lot of range of motion for that wrist.
Oh, that went long. Took the initiative, stepped in.
It's funny that I spend so much time speaking about the advantages of penhold, considering the clear disadvantage, simply that more people would be using it if there were so many advantages over shake hands. But one of the advantages is that in terms of hitting the table with your hand, the racket is lower and hangs down, so I think it's easier to play the ball when it's near the back of the table.
Come on. Marlin's on his feet. You like that one?
Yeah, he's got a lot of passion. He was a fighter indeed while he was playing, and he's a fighter from the coach's corner as well. Different levels of passion from the coaching corner, but Ma Lin's is pretty high up there. That is too strong. Not much you can do about that. Wow. But they were down 1-5, if I remember correctly, at the first towel break. And they've turned things around quite significantly. Nine-seven. That's the type of shot it needs, giving Xuxin a taste of his own medicine. An inside-out forehand with full commitment on the step around. Beautiful shot. He had to come across the chest to keep it low, quick and surprising, and still was side spin. Fun fact for the fans out there, maybe you already knew this, Maharu Yoshimura, half Filipino. Good touch to keep it low just behind the net. Malin's been on his feet a lot this match, but after all, it is the championship match to take a title from the nation that is, well, the greatest threat to the Chinese domination right now. And even if they're still in second by a little ways, Tokyo 2020, just 1 year away. And Japan is working quite hard to bring a lot of smiles to the home crowd. Two game points. Oh, it is too pretty. Where was he gonna go? I'm sure we could see a replay of this. And just before he hits it, we would have very little to no sign of where he's going to go. Xuxin, the world's best double player, and Liu Shuwen really on fire this tournament. Go up 2-0, and we'll be back for game number 3 right after this. For game number 3, Japanese pair starting to fall into a bit of a deficit here. They're going to have to climb their way out. Down 0-2 on the receive. Good setup, good length. Xuxin apologizing, playing a little bit more cautiously in between. I think that was a term that he used when he was interviewed after his loss against Simon Gozi. A bit too cautious. Ishikawa with the flick to start it off. Drive Xuxin back a little bit behind the table. And Yoshimura has to keep the risk factor high. Short stroke, very little backswing, and drills it on the parallel for the winner. Heavy, heavy underspin from Ishikawa. Wow, Xuxin recovered a netball with a low aggressive backhand counter loop, but it didn't faze Yoshimura. Maharu Yoshimura right on top of the bounce again with another parallel winner. Inside out spin at that. ridiculous. No, it's not. It's Xu Xin. It's just his standard. He chases it down the cloud walker wide to the forehand, recovering the net ball once again. And all that side spin you talked about, Jill, it's there. Look at it. It's so prevalent in his game. You're just thinking about Kasumi's new eyelashes?
Yeah, you told me about that in the break.
I understand.
I can't say I've had a look, but I'll take your word for it.
Can't say what?
I can't. I haven't seen them, so I'll take your word for it.
Okay. Maybe we'll get a close-up later. We'll see. Maybe one of those slow-motion choles. Clever idea, Xu Xin changing the pace, because the last few times he's counter-looped aggressively, Maharu Yoshimura set himself up at a good distance with a short stroke to counter for the winner. So Xu Xin has a lot going on up there quite quickly.
Oh, lovely there by Ishikawa. Took that straight off the bounce. Counter top spin. Nice and fast on the diagonal.
It's actually so fast that we almost saw a shot. Up, it's your chance. Could just be mascara. I was gonna say, it was so fast. I love seeing things I've never seen before in table tennis. And I call Xu Xin my brother from another mother, because he likes seeing and giving people something to see. Well, me too at a much lower level, but giving people something that they've never seen before to enjoy. And one thing I've never seen in doubles that could have happened in theory, that fast shot was right at Liu Xiwen's body. Xu Xin played it from behind Liu Xiwen. If he had played it around Liu Xiwen and around the net for a winner, I mean, I don't know. How does your head not explode? Good placement, Liu Xiwen deep to the backhand corner as Ishikawa was moving in to cover the open forehand. They had 8-1, I think. Two in a row now for the Chinese pair. Wow.
Oh, that was a great forehand flick there.
It didn't look very low. We might get an, I mean, it looked very low. It didn't look very easy to attack. I'm curious to see it from this angle right here. Thank you so much. Don said it before, but the production's been outstanding. Net height. Deepest corner of the table, right into the shorts.
And his arm was so straight as well, it was just wrist.
Hashtag full extension.
As you say, the camera angles have been superb here. They've got 17 on this table.
Oh, short side again. Xu Xin, with that much heat on the forehand, sends the ball smoking down the forehand line. Strawberry a little bit soft, though. That's when a strawberry's gone bad, when it starts to get soft. I learned that from my mom, Jill. Shout out to my mom. I miss you. Good pressure here with Xu Xin behind the table, playing it as wide into the backhand to deter that step around. And now 6 game points for the Japanese pair, the defending gold medalists. Well, that was probably a really heavy underspin shot. I felt like Kasumi was caught between adding side spin to it and just a straight push, which is why it went down so quickly. When you're warned to please play, it's quite common. We see it in a lot of the top China versus China matches. It's a sign of respect, but also a sign of trouble, that you know you need to be so clear on your game plan coming into the serve, or even the receive in some cases. Xu Xin has been on the winning end of so many devastating comebacks. And as you mentioned, Liu Xiwen had her 11-0 win in the fifth against Ding Ning. Against Ding Ning! I mean,
no, it was unbelievable.
Oh, man. The Queen of Hearts, that is almost blasphemous. I don't know what the word is when it's an action, not a spoken crime. They're trying. They're really looking for some risky, bold play here. Here it is, two game points left. Oh, man. That is tough, especially in doubles, to play a shot like this. You have to wonder, timeout here? This is a very late timeout, Jill. I mean, five game points in a row have been spent. Fans, compose yourselves. 10-9. One more game point here for the Japanese pair. Crucial turning point in the match. Oh, there it is, tighter serve over the table. Would love to see this one from a few angles, but it is all in the past. It is 1-2 now, the Japanese pair. Here's a look. Shallow, half long, looked heavy. Here we go back for game number four. Jill and I having a blast between games. As far as blasts go, the blasts of Shushin have been shut down a little bit at the very end of a very scary comeback for the Japanese pair. Oh, that surprise flick, Liu Shiwen, quite crafty. I mean, this is a tactic that in the women's singles event, we don't see quite so commonly, to step in for a forehand flick out wide. But here in the mixed doubles, I mean, that really paid off.
Japanese saying that touched the net. Chinese say it didn't. Not sure what the umpire is saying.
Mahadu Yoshimura was quite quick to call that. And they both thought so. So it would be an odd coincidence that they both, I mean, in theory, if it were an alibi, you wouldn't expect them to agree on it without having any planning. So they clearly thought it hit the net, but if it did, it was ever so faint. So the point was awarded. I think they let the point go, the Japanese pair.
Oh, there we see that flick again.
That is what happened, right? They agreed, okay, we'll let it go.
Well, I think the umpire, you know, you have to play to the umpire.
Right.
And the umpire didn't see it and didn't, so she stuck to her first, you know, put the hand up to the Chinese.
This is one thing that I'm most, I'd say, in awe of, other than the physical fitness and the domination in general of the Chinese national team, but their ability to add topspin, taking the ball with such short strokes right off the bounce. I mean, that takes a lot of conditioning and drilling, really.
Oh, yeah, they've got such strong wrists to be able to do that and quick movement.
Especially with that heavy rubber on the forehand side. A nice parallel deception from Liu Shiwen. Remember, this is a player that in the women to men matches in China, granted they were given a few points to women, just a few advantages, Liu Shiwen didn't lose a single match to a man and won $10,000. Right now, that creativity is paying off out here quite a lot. Good parallel again. There are going to have to be a lot of parallels. Both teams with the righty-lefty combination for the forehand play. You were asking me about the compression shorts, right, Jill?
Yes, I was.
You know, I don't know if you've seen the video going around the internet of Ding Ning. She went out to play and forgot her skirt. She warmed up just in the compression shorts, and it's the most charming, funny reaction when she realizes that she couldn't stop smiling through the rest of the warm-up. I'll show it to you. I posted it on my Facebook or shared it recently, but it is so charming. I was thinking about it, looking at the compression shorts of Liu Shiwen. We still don't have a good answer for why the women's team, but not the men's team.
Well, I did ask Galia Dvorak.
What did Galia say?
And she says because of the movement, how quick, and they get strain in the inside the leg.
That makes a lot of sense. The women's game is a lot more hopping, a lot more side-to-side quick movements, which is part of the reason I always see them doing those rubber band stretches. You can see the Chinese national team on YouTube with elastic bands around their feet a lot. And in the men's game, there's a different type of turning and twisting at the waist and a little bit more time as opposed to the very speedy play and movement. So thank you, Galia, for that. I think Thank you, Jill, for fishing it in. Talked about the turning point last game. This game right here, the momentum really needs to continue for the Japanese pair. The idea is right for me, looking for the wide angle, testing the wingspan of a smaller player like Liu Shiwen.
Absolutely fantastic. It's like so early.
Yeah, and casually too. It's like she sees it in slow motion. Watch how relaxed she is. Very short stroke, just enough.
It's the anticipation.
Yeah, she knows the game so well. Having played Timo Boll once before, I can tell you, it's like they know before you know where it's going to go. And at this level, obviously, they bring a slightly greater threat than I do to Timo Boll. But, and by slightly, I mean enormously. But that's something they all have. From so much experience, it's like it's second nature to them. They know the patterns, they know the signs, the tells, and they get ready quickly. They get in position. Xu Xin scoops that up out of nowhere. It was tough to tell which side of the racket he played it with. It was clearly a backhand, but he's got two options here. Let's see, still too fast. The ball goes the other way. From that position, he comes across the ball. I want to see that from the other angle. Hopefully, we'll have a chance. I mean, naturally, the way the ball curved, it would have continued to jump into the body of Kasumi. This is like a snake from behind the table in clear sight. Wow. Above the table, snakes in clear sight, snakes. Those are the craziest. Timeout here. Xu Xin from behind the table with the forehands. I think that Hail Mary sort of backhand across the body that we still are not clear on what happened was not the tactic to win it. Just a last resort. A little bit flatter from Kasumi with the heavy, heavy topspin coming in. And now it is four game points for Xu Xin and Liu Shiwen to take a 3-1 lead. Very vocal, Ma Lin in the corner. Countered back, good anticipation again.
She's got to keep this one tight.
And she does, gets a passive receive out of Liu Shiwen. Maharu Yoshimura knows his job. He's on a mission to get that attack early. And as a taller player, a lankier player, maybe the tallest on the Japanese national team, probably alongside Harimoto, that forehand and again, that flexibility and agility that he has, that wrist action, pays off here to save one more game point. You want to see a celebration, keep the camera on Ma Lin if China wins this point. The Chinese pair, that is. Oh, brilliant receive. I mean, it's like there's no other option. There is no spoon. He looks at this and says, one choice, attack and find the place, that's it. I wonder if they can do anything. They've got a second serve here. Yoshimura on the receive again. Is there a tight enough serve that will shut down the flick? Can they force him into submission and a passive receive? Oh man, I was gonna say no. And it's true, he made his attack. They could not avoid the attack. A break off the net, it comes down into play and Kasumi under pressure. Back for game number five, one game away from stealing the title. They will have earned it. They've played incredible table tennis. And when Japan takes a gold medal at a World Championships, it definitely calls the attention of the top Chinese players in the CTTA, the Chinese Table Tennis Association, to respond. It's a little bit like a rap battle. Like a diss track. Japan speaks up. Of course, there's no disrespect here. That's what diss is short for. Fun fact, Jill. In case you hear someone saying diss. Oh, nice. Right down the line. The risk game right now. Yoshimura has been playing some incredible table tennis. Kasumi's had her share of shots, but under pressure in recent memory, she's had the short end of the stick indeed.
Nice. You see him standing to take receive a serve, and then last minute, he's so quick.
Chushin?
Yep.
Well, I mean, his feet barely touch the clouds, Jill.
It's the way he gets his wrist right the way around. It's that hurt when I did that.
Oh, Jill hurt her wrist doing a Shushin receive up here. It's okay, it would have hurt me too. Don't feel bad. Physically okay, emotionally no. No, Shushin! Shushin! My goodness, he's got every number on his accreditation right now. There is no place he can't go in the arena. He's up against the barrier. The timing of this ball from Kasumi and the angle. Oh, Shushin. Can you wipe off your shoe? You've got some cloud stuck on it, Cloudwalker. Oh, and it's a traditional backhand, too. How does that not hurt his wrist? He almost did a 360 with his wrist. He's Beetlejuice. Strawberry off the table. That's the type of shot that is so scarring. The point before I talked about it, the scar factor with Don. 1 point is only worth one. But when it takes your opponent out of the game mentally, it can cost a lot more than that, or earn a lot more for that, for the team that won. They are fired up as their jerseys. On his feet again, Jill.
Yeah, Marlin. And it's funny, because when you're a player, you're in control. But when you're a coach, you play every point.
That is unbelievable. This shot is so uncomfortable. I mean, 99% of the top 100 in the world, that might be an underestimation here, an understatement, miss this shot. Shushin lunges, comes out of nowhere with the forehand from barely near the ground. They barely off the ground, but either way, that forehand is devastating.
Yeah, that was good though, because he served nearer the white line, so that cut out the angle.
Doo-doom, 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 bass. You reminded me of a song, Jill.
Did you?
White lines.
Oh, white lines.
Grandmaster right. Flash. Melly Mel and Grandmaster Flash. They are very tough to stop right now. They are determined. I mean, for Shushin, you can imagine, right? Being knocked out by Simone Gauzy in the best opportunity of his life, and maybe the last opportunity to be a men's singles world champion. But he is going to have so many doubles, gold medals, and titles to his name.
Oh, so quick.
Yeah, these exchanges again, it's almost like they're trying to break a world record just on top of the bounce. Especially with these run-by shots. I mean, remember in doubles, if you're newer to table tennis, they have to alternate shots. No player can hit two in a row. So they're constantly moving through the field of play.
Ooh.
Oh, man. Haru Yoshimura. This is tough for Kasumi, because she gets a very winnable ball, and highlights are written all over this. Oh, not just for the title. I think that's the main focus here. Where's the racket? Oh, below the waist. Man. Look like a dance move. Yoshimura, one of the masters of behind the back. I think him and Daniel Habason of Austria have played that shot successfully more than anybody I've seen. I think Yoshimura had a point not too long ago where he played three in a row from through the legs. Maybe it was behind the back, and then he got an edge ball against Hatimoto, maybe?
All right, gosh.
Maybe it was behind the back, but man. Such a humble yet creative. He's got so much swag, but he's never in your face or cocky about it. He's very, very fair and kind. One of the nicest guys. 6 points ahead now. 2 points away from the title. Snake! Oh, just too much. Liu Xuan handled the snake really well. That's one of the most venomous snakes that I've seen at the professional level in years. I think the last one even in that category had to have been Xu Xin versus Fong Bo in Sweden in 2017. And now it is 7 game, match, and championship points to crown new champions in the mixed doubles event. Not yet. Xu Xin trying to race through, and he goes for it. It was a fine balance of cautious yet ambitious, Jill.
Yeah, well, they've been 10-4 down. They've got to try and do something positive.
Japanese pair definitely do. We've got a long way to go here. Oh, my goodness, what a way to end it. 2 in a row, and the teeth have shown. Xu Xin, the Cloud Walker, and Liu Xuan are the new mixed doubles world champions. A spectacular match. What an effort. Thank you, Kasumi Ishikawa and Maharu Yoshimura, for the show.